glad you're okay, Commander. Losing Jenkins was hard enough on the crew. I'm glad you're okay, Commander. Losing Jenkins was hard enough on the crew.
Good timing, Commander. I was just about to bring us into the Citadel. See that taxpayer money at work. Size isn't everything.
Why so touchy, Joker?
I'm just saying, you need firepower, too.
Look at that monster. Its main gun could rip through the barriers in any ship in the Alliance fleet.
Good thing it's on our side, then.
Citadel Control, this is SSV Normandy, requesting permission to land.
Stand by for clearance, Normandy. Clearance granted. You may begin your approach. Transferring you to an Alliance operator.
Roger, Alliance Tower.
Normandy, this is Alliance Tower. Please proceed to Dock 422.
It's an outrage! The Council would step in if the Geth attacked a Turian colony!
The Turians don't found colonies on the borders of the Terminus systems, Ambassador.
Humanity was well aware of the risks when you went into the Traverse.
What about Saren? You can't just ignore a rogue Spectre. I demand action!
You don't get to make demands of a Council, Ambassador.
Citadel Security is investigating your charges against Saren. We will discuss the CSEC findings at the hearing, not before.
Captain Anderson, I see you brought half your crew with you.
Just the ground team from Eden Prime, in case you had any questions.
I have the mission reports. I assume they're accurate?
They are. Sounds like you convinced the Council to give us an audience.
They were not happy about it. Saren's their top agent. They don't like him being accused of treason.
Saren's a threat to every human colony out there. He needs to be stopped. The Council has to listen to us.
Settle down, Commander. You've already done more than enough to jeopardize your candidacy for the Spectres. The mission on Eden Prime was a chance to prove you could get the job done. Instead, Nihlus ended up dead and the beacon was destroyed.
That's Saren's fault, not his.
Then we better hope the CSEC investigation turns up evidence to support our accusations. Otherwise, the Council might use this as an excuse to keep you out of the Spectres. Come with me, Captain. I want to go over a few things before the hearing. Shepard, you and the others can meet us at the Citadel Tower, top level. I'll make sure you have clearance to get in.
And that's why I hate politicians. This place is a little too perfect. Like they're hiding something.
Sure is peaceful here.
Thank you. understand what you're saying, but these allegations are very serious. I can't...
Hello there, human. Sincere apology, but I am here on business and cannot be distracted right now.
You seem distressed. Is there something I can do to help?
Alarmed response. You overheard that, did you? This is all going so wrong, and it is the Asari consort's fault. She's the one who started all this.
Who's this Asari consort?
Curious, you have not heard. You must be new to the Citadel. Everyone knows Shaira, the consort. I cannot speak more about this problem. It is too sensitive. Suffice it to say, she has compromised my authority as a diplomat.
Where can I find this Asari consort?
She is across the bridge from here. Her offices are easy enough to spot. Good day, human.
Pleased greeting. Human, it is always good to see your kind. I am Ambassador Kalin. Genuine query. Is there something I can do for you this day?
What do you do here?
Modestly. I work to bring the problems and the requests of the L-Corps groups to the attention of the Council.
Ha! They only give us these positions to keep us quiet. The Council doesn't care about our races.
Chastising rebuke. Your tone is inappropriate, Din. This human is not to blame for your malcontent or your misconceived suspicions.
Tell me more about your species.
Genuine enthusiasm. I delight in telling the history of my people. It is agreeable to share our culture with others.
I'd like to know more about the culture of the L-Corps.
Frankly, we L-Corps prefer the safety and familiarity of our own colonies to the confines of space travel. Our society is built on small, tight-knit groups, though we are always welcoming to outsiders. Our government tends to be very stable. Our people are not very comfortable with sudden changes.
Tell me about the history and origins of the L-Corps.
The L-Corps were just beginning to explore Council space when the Asari first made contact with us. With their help, we discovered the relay closest to our system, and from there the Citadel. Proudly, within one lifetime we established a regular route to the Citadel, and quickly became one of the more active species living on this great station.
Why do you explain what you're about to say?
Our people communicate less through words and more through scent and slight movements. Plainly, we discovered our vocal expression was not enough to convey the feelings of our conversations to other species.
Why do you bother, Kalin? These Earth Clan don't really care about our ways.
Remorseful response, Din. You don't truly believe that. And if you do, I am very sorry for you.
Goodbye, Ambassador.
Sincere farewell. Good day to you, human. Enjoy your time on the Citadel.
Earth Clan, you are in the wrong place, I think. Your ambassador is next door in the large office.
Chastising remark. Don't be so rude, Din. At least introduce yourself.
I am Din Korlak, Volus Ambassador. Is there something I can do for you, Earth Clan?
What is it you do here?
I look out for the best interests of the Volus people. No easy task considering how often we are overlooked by the Council.
Chastising rebuke, Din. The Council favors your species greatly.
You are naive. The Earth Clan will be invited to the Council long before our species will.
Why aren't the Volus or Elcor part of the Council?
All species must prove themselves before they join the Council. All but the Earth clans, it would seem.
Dismissive. Ignore the Volus ambassador, human. He is incorrect in his assessment.
Really? How long have we been waiting? How long do you think we'll continue to wait? Bah, this talk is wasted on the humans.
I'd like to know more about the Volus.
I'm sure our history and culture would bore you, Earth Clan.
Actually, I would like to know more about your history.
My people came to the Citadel shortly after the Asari and Salarians had discovered it. We were instrumental in establishing a standardized galactic economy. However, despite our long association with the Citadel and our many contributions to galactic society, we still do not hold a seat on the Council.
Tell me about Volus culture.
We are tribal by nature, but our ways are not violent. We barter and trade our lands and tribe members in order to increase status. Larger tribes often engulf smaller ones and eventually split again. Our society is very malleable, and our government is always shifting and changing. Since we're not physically adept, we trade our services for protection.
Tell me about Volus culture.
We are tribal by nature, but our ways are not violent. We barter and trade our lands and tribe members in order to increase status. Larger tribes often engulf smaller ones and eventually split again. Our society is very malleable, and our government is always shifting and changing. Since we're not physically adept, we trade our services for protection.
What is this place?
You are in the embassy for the Volus and the Elcor.
Your ambassador is next door, in his own office.
In this shared space, I aid my fellow Volus, when I'm not being interrupted.
Goodbye, Ambassador.
Yes, yes. Good day, Earth Clan.
Welcome to the Presidium. Allow me to be your guide. Greetings and welcome to the Presidium. My name is Avena, and I am pleased to be your virtual guide throughout this level of the Citadel Space Station.
What does that mean?
I am a fully interactive virtual intelligence, programmed to provide spontaneous guidance at predetermined locations of interest throughout this level of the Citadel. I may also be contacted through any of the Presidium VI terminals, should you require assistance.
Give me the tour.
You are standing at Presidium Tourism Terminal 1. On either side of this lobby are the embassies of the various Citadel races, along with CSEC headquarters. On the far end of this level, you can see the Citadel Tower, where the Council meets regularly to discuss matters of interstellar importance.
What can you tell me about the Citadel Council?
Originally, the Council consisted of representatives from the Asari and Salarians, the two dominant species in Citadel space. Roughly 1,304 galactic standard years ago, Turians were invited to join the Council in recognition of the role they played during the Krogan Rebellion. Since then, the three Council races have worked together to ensure the peaceful coexistence of the galactic community, while preserving individual autonomy for each species.
It can't be as simple as that. There must be problems somewhere in the system.
I am not programmed to make that kind of qualified judgment. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulations.
Do you know anything about Spectres?
The term Spectre is derived from the branch of special tactics and reconnaissance. Each Spectre agent is hand-picked by the Council. Their primary role is preserving galactic stability and resolving volatile situations that cannot be handled through normal political channels. In this role, they are granted extraterritorial rights and jurisdictions. Spectres answer to no law or authority except the Council itself.
Tell me about the embassies.
Each species in Citadel space important enough to be consulted on matters of galactic politics maintains an embassy on the Presidium. The Volus were the first non-Council species to be granted an embassy, roughly 2,384 galactic standard years ago. As Citadel space has expanded, more embassies have been added. The most recently added embassy belongs to your own species, humanity. It was added 19 galactic standard years ago, despite some rather vocal opposition.
Why were people trying to keep my species out?
Some species felt humanity was given preferential treatment. It often takes a century or more before a new species is granted an embassy. The Council gave a great deal of thought to this matter. In the end, they decided humanity's impact on Citadel space was significant enough to warrant an embassy.
Do you agree with their decision?
I am not programmed to make that kind of qualified judgment. My code is limited to information and simple interaction simulations.
How come the Volus were the first species given an embassy?
In the early years following the formation of the Council, the Volus were, apart from the Asari and Salarians, the most populous and widespread species in Citadel space. They established many new colonies and trading outposts, and they petitioned the Council for a greater role in determining interstellar policy. In recognition of their work to expand interstellar trade and establish a standardized galactic economy, the Volus were granted an embassy here on the Citadel.
Why weren't they made a Council race?
The Council races have extensive responsibilities. They must provide personnel and ships for the Citadel fleets. They often provide economic aid in times of disaster. It would be unfair to demand such an enormous burden of a species unable to meet these obligations. The embassies allow lesser species to have a voice on the Citadel.
That's pretty damn arrogant.
I apologize if my personality has offended you. Please submit all formal complaints in writing to the Citadel Tourist and Visitor Board.
I want to know more about Citadel security.
Citadel security serves as law enforcement for all regions of the Citadel, though the majority of officers serve in the wards. Executor Palin, a Turian, is the current head of CSEC, but individuals from virtually every species across Citadel space serve as officers beneath him. If you wish to learn more, Executor Palin's office is located in the CSEC headquarters just across the lobby.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, and thank you for using Avena. Please enjoy your visit to the Citadel.
Good day, Commander. The human ambassador is up the stairs, first room on the right.
What is this place?
This is the Presidium. More specifically, you are at the Citadel Embassies. If you have more questions, please access Avena.
What's that?
Oh, Avena is the virtual guide for the Citadel. Feel free to access the terminal yourself.
What's your name? What do you do here?
My name is Sepheria. I'm the administrative assistant for the embassies.
You seem to be distracted.
The embassies are the hub of all Citadel politics. When you represent trillions of citizens, it tends to get a little busy.
I should be going now.
Have a pleasant day.
Human, delighted welcome. It is good to meet you.
I can't believe I landed a job here. This place is fantastic.
Commander Shepard. I didn't expect to see you here. Did Ambassador Udina send you?
Have we met before?
No, but I know you well enough. I'm Executor Palin, head of CSEC. It's my job to know when someone like you arrives on the Citadel. Was there something you needed, Commander?
Tell me about CSEC.
CSEC provides necessary police and security services throughout the Citadel. We're a civilian government agency, though many of our members have had military training. Of course, as the CSEC representative to the Council, I spend most of my time liaising between the two.
Tell me about your investigation into Saren.
Sorry, Commander. I don't make a habit of giving out details about ongoing investigations.
What do you know about the Spectres?
They're the right hand of the Council, or so they like to be called. More like the underhanded side of the Council.
What do you have against the Spectres?
I can't abide any organization that considers itself above the law. Especially when it's left up to each individual Spectre to decide when and how to bend the rules.
Sometimes you have to bend the law to keep people safe.
I've been with CSEC for 30 years. I've never had to break the law to do my job, not once.
Yeah, right. You expect us to believe none of your officers are corrupt?
There are over 200,000 CSEC agents. Some of them are going to be bad. But we don't turn a blind eye to corruption like the Spectres do. We do our best to find and punish any officer who breaks the law. Spectres. They'll never come under that kind of scrutiny.
The galaxy needs people like that. People who do the dirty jobs.
I agree. But they need to be held to a higher standard. They need to be accountable. Saren's out of control. We both know that. But because he's a Spectre, the Council doesn't want to do anything about it. Is that the kind of person this galaxy needs?
Absolutely. The only thing that matters is accomplishing the task.
Maybe. But I've never had to cross that line to get the job done. Never.
I get the feeling you're not too fond of humans.
No, I just don't trust your kind. Not yet. You humans are eager to take all the power you can get, and you're being given a lot. If the Council wants to make humanity their new favorite pet, that's their business. But I don't have to like it.
The Council treats us like second-class citizens. We have to fight for everything we get.
Good. Then fight for it. But don't expect the rest of us to just sit back and let you take it. I'm a busy man, Commander. Are we done here?
I'll be going now.
Goodbye, Commander.
This place seems strange. Wish there were more humans around.
Trunfle, what do you want?
Oh, Commander. Is there something I can do for you?
Relax, Private. This isn't an inspection.
Right, sorry. What can I do for you, Commander?
What can you tell me about the Asari consort?
Well, she's an Asari who works here as... That is, she helps people with... things.
You never went to see her, did you, Fredericks?
No, I never did. I couldn't afford it. It costs half a year's credits just to go in and talk to her.
Can you at least tell me where I can find her?
Sure. She's across the bridge from the embassies.
Thanks, kid. Have fun. Try not to get into too much trouble.
I will. Have fun, that is.
Hello, Commander. Can I get you something?
What have you got?
Information, mostly. Would you like to know about some points of interest nearby?
What's going on around here?
Well, you found the embassies. Not much going on here. Across the bridge, you'll find the bank, the Emporium, and Shiera's. If you haven't heard of her, you soon will. If you need supplies, you can try the markets one level below. For entertainment, I'd try Flux or Korra's Den.
What is Shiera's?
The consort? She entertains clients who can afford her services. Most of the diplomats and ambassadors have visited her at one time or another. She's a very powerful woman, but also very respected.
Tell me about Flux and Korra's Den.
Well, Flux has gambling and dancing, certainly more lively than this place. Korra's Den, on the other hand, well, let's just say it's livelier and deadlier, all at the same time.
Goodbye.
So long, Commander. Have a pleasant day.
I don't have time to talk now. I'm very busy. I can't tell the aliens from the animals.
Sure is peaceful here.
Saren's hiding something. Give me more time. Stall them.
Stall the Council? Don't be ridiculous. Your investigation is over, Garrus.
Commander Shepard, Garrus Vakarian. I was the officer in charge of the CSEC investigation into Saren.
Sounds like you really want to bring him down.
I don't trust him. Something about him rubs me the wrong way. But he's a Spectre. Everything he touches is classified. I can't find any hard evidence.
I think the Council's ready for us, Commander.
Good luck, Shepard. Maybe they'll listen to you. You don't want to keep the Council waiting.
I like that fountain. It's very soothing.
I'm waiting to speak with one of the Counselor's assistants.
Commander?
The hearing's already started. Come on.
The Geth attack is a matter of some concern. But there is nothing to indicate Saren was involved in any way.
The investigation by Citadel Security turned up no evidence to support your charge of treason.
An eyewitness saw him kill Nihlus in cold blood.
We've read the Eden Prime reports, Ambassador. The testimony of one traumatized dock worker is hardly compelling proof.
I resent these accusations. Nihlus was a fellow Spectre and a friend.
That just let you catch him off guard.
Captain Anderson, you always seem to be involved when humanity makes false charges against me. And this must be your protege, Commander Shepard. The one who let the beacon get destroyed.
The mission to Eden Prime was top secret. The only way you could know about the beacon was if you were there.
With Nihlus gone, his files passed on to me. I read the Eden Prime report. I was unimpressed. But what can you expect from a human?
You can expect me to kill you the next time we meet.
Your species needs to learn its place, Shepard. You're not ready to join the Council. You're not even ready to join the Spectres.
He has no right to say that. That's not his decision.
Shepard's admission into the Spectres is not the purpose of this meeting.
This meeting has no purpose. The humans are wasting your time, Counselor, and mine.
You can't hide behind the Council forever.
There is still one outstanding issue. Commander Shepard's vision. It may have been triggered by the beacon.
Are we allowing dreams into evidence now? How can I defend my innocence against this kind of testimony?
I agree. Our judgment must be based on facts and evidence, not wild imaginings and reckless speculation.
Do you have anything else to add, Commander Shepard?
You've made your decision. I won't waste my breath.
The Council has found no evidence of any connection between Saren and the Geth. Ambassador, your petition to have him disbarred from the Spectres is denied.
I'm glad to see justice was served.
This meeting is adjourned.
It was a mistake bringing you into that hearing, Captain. You and Saren have too much history. It made the Council question our motives.
I know Saren. He's working with the Geth for one reason. To exterminate the entire human race. Every colony we have is at risk. Every world we control is in danger. Even Earth isn't safe.
Tell me about this history between you and Saren.
I worked with him on a mission a long time ago. Things went bad. Real bad. We shouldn't talk about this here. But I know what he's like. And he has to be stopped.
What's our next step?
As a Spectre, he's virtually untouchable. We need to find some way to expose him.
What about Garrus, that CSEC investigator? We saw him arguing with the Executor.
That's right. He was asking for more time to finish his report. Seems like he was close to finding something on Saren.
He's a Turian. I don't want him on our side.
Not all Turians are like Saren. If he can help, we need to find him.
I have a contact in CSEC who can help us track Garrus down. His name is Harkin.
Forget it. They suspended Harkin last month, drinking on the job. I won't waste my time with that loser.
You won't have to. I don't want the Council using your past history with Saren as an excuse to ignore anything we turn up. Shepard will handle this.
You can't just cut Captain Anderson out of this investigation.
The Ambassador's right. I need to step aside.
I need to take care of some business. Captain, meet me in my office later.
Harkin's probably getting drunk at Cora's den. It's a dingy little club in the lower section of the wards.
Maybe there's another way to find evidence against Saren.
You should talk to Barla Vaughn over in the financial district. Rumor has it he's an agent for the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker?
An information dealer. Buys and sells secrets to the highest bidder. I've heard Barla Vaughn's one of the top representatives. He might know something about Saren, but his information won't come cheap.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove a known terrorist threat. Saren eliminated his target, but a lot of people died along the way, innocent people. And the official records just covered it all up. But I saw how he operates. No conscience. No hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
Killing innocents doesn't end wars, it causes them.
I know how the world works, Commander. Sometimes you're forced to make unpleasant decisions. But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Sometimes 1,000 people must die so 1,000,000 can live.
But only if there's no other way. Saren doesn't even look for another option. He's twisted, broken. He likes the violence, the killing. And he knows how to cover his tracks.
Our ambassador doesn't seem to get along with the Council.
He's just frustrated. The Council's always preaching that we need to be part of the galactic community. But for them, it's a one-way street. They want us to expand and settle unstable regions like the Skillian Verge and the Attican Traverse. But when we run into trouble, they don't want to help us out. Everyone knows it's only a matter of time until we get a seat on the Council. The ambassador just thinks it should happen sooner rather than later. And I agree.
You and Saren have a history. What happened?
About 20 years ago, I was part of a mission in the Skillian Verge. I was working with Saren to find and remove... Saren eliminated his target, but I saw how he operates. No conscience. No hesitation. He'd kill 1,000 innocent civilians to end a war without a second thought.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
He's a necessary evil of galactic politics. Buying and selling information is a part of the game. And the Shadow Broker just happens to be the best player on the field. Always sells to the highest bidder. Doesn't get involved in politics. Doesn't pick sides. A simple system, but it works. He's not a threat to anyone, not directly. He's just a resource we can use, or she is, or maybe they are. Nobody really knows.
Tell me about Barlavon.
He specializes in moving large sums of money without leaving a paper trail. A financial genius, doesn't do anything illegal, but he knows all the loopholes. He's got an impressive client list. Ambassadors, diplomats, specters. That's probably why the Shadow Broker uses him.
You don't think much of Harkin.
The guy joined CSEC about 20 years ago. He's been an embarrassment to our species ever since. Roughing up suspects in custody, bribery accusations, alcohol and drug use. The embassy used to step in when he got in trouble. But I guess enough was enough.
The guy's a scumbag. He should have been cut loose a long time ago.
He was one of the first human CSEC officers. Guess it would have looked bad if he got fired. A lot of backroom deals were worked out over the years to keep him on the force. Politics is a dirty business sometimes, but it looks like his time's run out. We've got enough humans in CSEC now to stop protecting him.
I thought this embassy was supposed to help humans.
Harkin may be human, but he's also an ass. He's had more than his share of chances. If the embassy wasn't protecting him, he would have been fired 15 years ago. CSEC is better off without him.
I want to know more about the Spectres.
They're not your typical government agency. They tend to work alone, behind the scenes. They take care of problems the Council can't. It's not easy preserving peace across an entire galaxy. The Council prefers to use diplomacy and negotiation. But sometimes more extreme measures are needed.
They sound like shadow operatives.
Everything about them is classified. We don't even know how many there are. The latest Alliance estimate puts their numbers under 100. But the Council couldn't do its job without them. They're the Citadel's top agents, the last line of defense, the final option before open war. The entire galaxy respects and fears them. If a Spectre shows up, you know something big is about to happen.
What happens when a Spectre goes rogue, like Saren?
It doesn't happen often. The Council is careful when they select their candidates. But when something does go wrong, there's usually only one solution. Send another Spectre to bring the rogue agent down.
How do they decide who becomes a Spectre?
You can't just apply to join. There's no training program. Spectres aren't made. They're born. The Council's always looking for exceptional individuals. People who can get the job done, like you. They've been watching you for years. They see something in you. They want you on their side. Nihlus was supposed to give them a final recommendation, but with him gone, things are still up in the air.
What's their command structure like?
There is no command structure. Each Spectre answers directly to the Council. Sometimes they're sent on specific missions. Other times, they act on their own. They tend to operate outside the law, do whatever it takes to accomplish their goals. The Council just turns a blind eye. Spectres have a lot of power, Shepard.
I should go.
Good luck, Shepard. I'll be over in the Ambassador's office if you need anything else.
The Asari were the first, the second species, roughly 12. The Elkor. The Volus are a member species of the Citadel with their own embassy, but they are also a client race of the Turians. Centuries ago, they were voluntarily absorbed into the hierarchy, effectively trading their mercantile prowess for Turian military protection. Erun, their homeworld, lies far beyond the normal life zone of its star. However, the world has a high-pressure greenhouse atmosphere that traps enough heat to support an ammonia-based biochemistry. As a result, the Volus must wear pressure suits and breathers when dealing with other species, as conventional nitrogen-oxygen air mixtures are poisonous to them, and in the low-pressure atmospheres tolerable to most species, their flesh will actually split open. Volus culture is tribal, bartering lands and even people to gain status. This culture of exchange inclines them to economic pursuits. It was the Volus who authored the Unified Banking Act, and they continue to monitor and balance the Citadel economy. The Council is an executive committee A virtual intelligence is an advanced form of user...
guy's a...
That Hanar refuses to listen to reason. Why can't it act in an orderly and lawful manner?
You should be more tolerant. It's just trying to express its beliefs.
I am not unreasonable. The Hanar is free to spew its nonsense once it purchases an evangelical permit.
If you'd like, I could talk to the Hanar for you.
I have argued with the stubborn jelly all afternoon. You are certainly welcome to try.
Do you desire to learn of the Enkindlers? Or has the Honorable CSEC officer enlisted assistance?
Is this really how you want to represent the Enkindlers?
The truth of the Enkindlers must be made known. They gave the Hanar language, and gave the universe the mass relays. This one only wishes to spread the truth to any who will listen. There is no intent to cause trouble.
What if I purchase the evangelical permit for you?
Finances are only a partial limitation. This one does not believe that one should pay in order to speak the truth. However, this one also does not possess the 150 credits necessary to purchase the permit.
150 credits? This should cover you.
This is a most appreciated action. You are not of the Hanar, but you wish to help spread the truth of the Enkindlers. This one will not cause any further trouble for the CSEC officer. This one offers its thanks.
I see the Hanar is left. Thank you.
Happy to help.
Here, for your assistance in this matter. Now if you'll excuse me, I should report to my superiors.
That bug thing over there. What's it?
Please do not disturb the keepers.
Welcome to Presidium Tourism Terminal 2. You are standing near the base of the Citadel Tower, one of the Presidium's most recognizable and important structures. Behind me is the Spectacular Relay Monument, a scale model representation of a Prothean mass relay. To your left is one of the Keepers, the enigmatic caretakers of the Citadel, working on a control panel. You may see Keepers involved in various tasks throughout all levels of the Citadel. We ask that you do not interfere with them in any way. The Keepers are essential to the smooth operation of the Citadel. Obstructing their daily work will result in harsh penalties, including incarceration and rehabilitation.
Tell me about the Citadel Tower.
Housing both the Council Chambers and Citadel Control, the tower is one of the most important buildings on the station. Access to these areas is restricted to those with the appropriate clearance.
What happens in Citadel Control?
Citadel Control handles all incoming and outbound transit. Every ship within 2,000 kilometers of the Citadel is under the jurisdiction of Citadel Control. At peak capacity, they are responsible for monitoring upwards of 1,000 vessels.
I'd like to hear more about the Council Chambers.
The business of the Council, which often has far-reaching effects on the galactic community, is conducted in a room at the apex of the Citadel Tower. The Council Chambers themselves are truly a magnificent sight to behold, though few get to experience the view in person. Typically, only the councilors, ambassadors, and high-ranking officials, along with various support staff, are allowed access.
What if someone has business with the Council?
The average citizen must go through the proper channels if they wish an audience with the Council. This is usually arranged through their respective ambassadors. Even then, few are given access to the actual Council Chambers. In most cases, the ambassador acts on behalf of the citizen.
I've been inside the Council Chambers.
Only a handful of visitors to the Citadel are ever granted that privilege. I would be jealous, but that is outside the scope of my programming.
I'd like to know more about the Keepers.
Little is known about these peaceful servants of the Citadel, though they are essential to the operation and maintenance of the entire station. Citadel regulations protect the Keepers against interference during the performance of their tasks. Failure to comply will result in harsh penalties. Keepers can be seen in all sections of the Citadel, but are typically found in and around the tower.
Any particular reason there are so many Keepers in this area?
The Keepers do not communicate with other species. It is assumed, however, that the tower houses the Citadel's primary control systems. Many of the station's systems, such as navigation and life support, function automatically. It is believed the Keepers operate those systems from inside the tower's inaccessible core. The Keepers also make frequent appearances in the Council Chamber itself, though they appear to be just passing through on their way to some other destination.
Tell me about the Relay Monument.
Discovered by the Asari who first arrived at the Citadel, the Relay Monument is one of the station's most interesting and controversial features. What is the meaning behind this striking piece of art? Is it a tribute to Prothean vanity? A reminder of their conquest of the galaxy through mass relay technology? Or perhaps it is a symbol of unity? A Prothean acknowledgement that the relays would eventually lead other species here to the Citadel. No one can say for sure, making the Relay Monument a favorite topic of discussion among academics and scholars.
That's all for now.
Thank you for using Avena. Have a pleasant day.
What's this? One of the Earth Clan. Ah, a very famous one, yes? You are the one called Shepherd. The tale of how you survived the great tragedy on Akuz is truly remarkable. I am amazed each time I hear it.
You've got me at a disadvantage here.
Forgive me, Earth Clan. My name is Barla Vaughn. My job makes it necessary for me to keep informed. I am a financial advisor to many important clients here on the Citadel. When someone as important as yourself arrives on the station, I take notice.
I've heard you work for the Shadow Broker. Do you have any information about Saren?
You're very blunt, Shepard. But you're right. I am an agent for the Shadow Broker. And I do know something about Saren.
I need that information. Now.
Threats don't work on me, Commander. This information is worth a small fortune. But this is an unusual situation. So I am going to let you have it for free.
What's the catch?
There is no catch. The Shadow Broker is quite upset with Saren right now. They used to do a lot of business, until Saren turned on him.
That's what happens when you deal with a traitor like Saren.
No matter what you think of Saren, he's not stupid. He knows the Shadow Broker is a valuable ally. Turning on him doesn't make sense. Not unless something huge was at stake. I don't know the details, but the Shadow Broker hired a freelancer to deal with it. A Krogan mercenary.
How do I find him?
I heard he was paying Citadel Security a visit. If you hurry, you can probably catch him before he leaves the CSEC Academy.
Isn't it strange that a Krogan would want to speak with CSEC?
Very. However, I doubt the visit was entirely his choice. You'll need to speak with him if you want to know more.
Tell me more about your job.
Galactic finance is incredibly complex. A mix of laws and regulations from dozens of interstellar economies. I'm an expert in how all these economies interact. For a fee, I share my expertise. I also offer premium services for those clients who need someone to conduct business without drawing unwanted attention. Discreet and efficient. That's my motto.
Sounds pretty shady.
Everything I do falls completely within the bounds of interstellar commerce law. Even so, many of my clients would prefer their transactions remain undisclosed. For example, suppose a Hanar ambassador was petitioning the Council to reduce tariffs on Hanar goods. How would it look if he had money invested in a Hanar exporting company? Even if his true motives were to help his people, he would be accused of advancing the petition for his own personal gain. I can keep his personal finances private.
Still sounds shady to me.
Then we can only hope he will never be cursed with a large enough fortune to require my services.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
Most people think I deal in finances, but my real currency is knowledge. I trade information, and it has made me very wealthy. But the Shadow Broker is the true master. Every day he buys and sells secrets that could topple governments. Always giving them to the highest bidder. Yet somehow he never seems to upset the natural balance of power. All those secrets being passed around seem to even out. Nobody ends up with an advantage in the end.
Any guess what his identity might be?
I don't know. Nobody does. The Shadow Broker could be any race, any gender. I have a theory that it's actually an entire group working under one identity. How else could they juggle so many contacts at the same time? How else could they keep all that information from getting crossed? But they've got the perfect setup. Every government is forced to play their game so they don't get behind. But no matter how long you play, no matter how many secrets you buy, you can never win.
I thought you'd know more about the man you work for.
From time to time, I come across information I sell to the Shadow Broker. That's my only involvement. I like it that way. The more you know, the more dangerous the game becomes. I don't like danger, Commander. I'll leave that to you.
What's it like living here on the Citadel?
The station is, without a doubt, the greatest wonder in the galaxy. It is a technological marvel, but its true splendor goes much deeper than the hull and engines. From the Presidium to the wards, the entire station is a testament to the success of the Council. All the species of Citadel spaced together in a single, strong community.
What makes the Presidium so special?
It is the political center of Citadel space. 80% of all intelligent species in the known galaxy acknowledge the Council's authority on interstellar matters. But only the most powerful and influential species have embassies here on the Presidium. This level of the station is reserved for the elite, Shepard. People like us.
What are the wards like?
The cultural heart of the galaxy. They pulse with the lifeblood of millions of citizens from dozens of different species. You never know what you'll find out in the wards, Commander. It's always full of surprises. Fortunately, most of them are pleasant.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Human, this one is greatly pleased to see you here in my decadent emporium.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder, though many in this place simply refer to it as Delan. Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase, all of great worth.
Show me your items.
Oh, this one is pleased to do so, human. You will not be disappointed.
Thank you. had my office rearranged 5 times now.
5 times? Why?
Welcome. I am Nelina. I don't recognize you as one of our expected clients today. Would you like me to see when the consort will be able to meet with you?
Can't I just go in?
I'm afraid not. Yeah, you must understand there are many who seek the consort services. But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
What do you do here, Nelina?
I'm one of the consort's acolytes. Many of the people here today will not see the consort, but they expect to be attended to just the same. It's our job to ensure that they leave contented.
What exactly do you attend to?
Well, each acolyte has her unique abilities. Some soothe with song, others with conversation. As much as possible, we seek to match the needs of our clients to the skills of our acolytes. My specialty is touch. My fingertips can find every tension point in your body and relieve it.
I'd like to try out your services.
Excellent. I'll add you to our client list. We should be able to see you in 3 or 4 months.
Nobody's worth that much of a wait.
Well, that's not for me to judge. I have your name and you'll be contacted. Is there anything else?
What is the consort? What does she do?
It's difficult to explain. She's many things to many people, and something different for each. Some seek her for advice, some for entertainment, others still for pleasure. Most of the time, our clients won't realize what they were seeking until after she has provided it for them.
You make her sound like some kind of oracle.
No, not in the usual sense. She's merely a woman. A woman with remarkable compassion and a generous spirit. I suggest you make an appointment and see for yourself.
I think I'm done here.
Oh, well, I hope you'll return again in the future. We always enjoy seeing new clients.
Nelina.
Yes, Shaira?
Send the commander up to see me. I wish to speak with him.
Yes, of course, mistress. It appears the consort has taken notice of you. She'd like to meet with you now.
Where do I go?
Just head upstairs. She'll be waiting for you.
This is my first time. I can't believe I didn't come sooner.
You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
That is close enough, Commander. I've heard a great many things about you since your arrival here in our Citadel.
What exactly do you do?
That depends on your needs. I offer advice to some, comfort to others. I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Maybe I can help.
I have a friend, Septimus, a retired Turian general. I won't discuss the details, but He wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he spends his days in Cora's den, drinking and spreading lies about me. If you would speak to him as a fellow soldier, I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
What exactly do you want me to tell him?
Appeal to his sense of honor. Remind him of his position as a general. If you can convince him to stop spreading lies about me, I would be very grateful. Now I must ask you to take your leave. I have many clients waiting to see me.
This place is a little too perfect. Like they're hiding something.
Sure is peaceful here.
Please, Commander. I ask that you return to me only after you have spoken with Septimus.
See, even the humans find the consort irresistible.
How can I be of assistance to you today, Earth Clan?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
In light of the recent attack on Eden Prime, many colonial investors are pulling their support for future projects. Proponents of expanded human colonization insist that Eden Prime was an isolated case. Nevertheless, colonist enrollment has dropped sharply. Many colonial proposals are on hold until backers have some reassurance that human colonies will be adequately protected.
Do you really think we'll find him down here?
He always stops in for a few games of Quasar before he makes his drop.
Fist is gonna be pissed if we take down his supplier.
That's the point. We want him angry. Angry people make this.
A A Salarian excavation team has run into an unexpected problem after unearthing a Prothean dig site. Hanar protesters have blockaded the dig site, claiming that artifacts of the Enkindlers, as the Hanar call them, should not be disturbed. The excavation team has appealed to Hanar representatives on the Citadel to reach a diplomatic solution.
I'm Emily Wong. I'm an investigative journalist working here on the Citadel. Could I have a moment of your time?
What do you need?
I've been hunting for evidence of corruption and organized crime on the Citadel, but there are places I can't go. I was hoping you might share anything you find during your own investigation. I can make it worth your time.
How do you know that my investigation is going to uncover anything you need?
You wouldn't be investigating if it weren't big. And if it's big, it's something I'd like to hear about.
You've got to have access to better sources. Why contact me?
I'm using every source I can find, but I think I've got a better shot with you. According to your file, you survived back on Akuz when everyone else in your squad got killed. If anyone can find the worst elements of the Citadel and live to tell about it, it's you.
How do you know I'm investigating anything here on the Citadel?
I'm a good journalist, Commander Shepard. Word gets around.
No promises, but if I find anything relating to your case, I'll inform you.
Thank you, Commander. You won't regret it.
On this ward to buy upgrades. Prices are pretty good here.
Hello, Clan. No doubt you've just come back from the colonies. Will you be needing supplies?
What colonies are you talking about?
Oh, my mistake, Earth Clan. I assumed... It doesn't matter. Pharos? Novaria? Well, if you haven't heard of them yet, I'm sure you will soon. But it doesn't matter where you hail from. My goods are available to all.
What can you tell me about Novaria?
The corporate capital of the Attican Traverse. Very cold. Very snowy. I don't get too many clients from there. They all have their own private suppliers.
I'd like to know more about Pharos.
It's an old Prothean world. Their buildings still litter the surface. The humans aren't the first to colonize it, but they are the most recent. I just realized I haven't heard from my contact on that planet for some time. Well, I'm sure he's fine.
Show me what you've got.
Most excellent. I am sure you will find something pleasing.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous shop. You want many good supplies, yes?
Let me see what you have.
Oh, you will be pleased, I think. Very good things I have. You will see.
That's him.
Think they're here because of the food?
Business here, but not with you.
Not now. I'm watching the show.
Commander! What do you want?
I'm here on Shayira's behalf. Your lies are hurting her.
Good! Her lies have been killing me for days. I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and the There's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
So if you feel that way, then why spread lies about her?
'Cause she rejected me. Me! Septimus Araka, General of the Turian Fleet.
I think I can see why you're upset, but spreading these lies won't make it better.
Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
Enjoy your drink, General.
Yeah, off you go. See you later, kid.
I don't feel right just leaving like this.
Don't waste your time, kid. Run away now, while you still can.
Goodbye, General.
Yeah. It's for the best.
Hey, that was your first, pal. Guess you're on the spot.
Alliance Military. I could have been a Marine, you know. Instead, I joined the goddamn Citadel Security. Biggest mistake of my life.
Harkin, right? I was told you could help me find someone. A Turian CSEC officer named Garrus.
Garrus? You must be one of Captain Anderson's crew. Poor bastard, still trying to bring Saren down, eh? I know where Garrus is, but you gotta tell me something first. Did the captain let you in on his big secret?
Is there something I should know about the captain?
The captain used to be a Spectre. Didn't know that, did you? It was all very hush-hush. The first human ever given that honor, and then he blew it. Screwed up his mission so bad they kicked him out. Of course, he blames Saren. Says the Turians set him up.
You said they covered all this up. How'd you hear about it?
I spent 20 years working cases here on the Citadel. People on this station love to talk. Secrets are like herpes. If you got them, you might as well spread them around.
You're a pig.
Just noticed that now, did you?
Just tell me where Garrus went.
Garrus was sniffing around Dr. Michelle's office. She runs the med clinic on the other side of the wards. Last I heard, he was going back there.
How well do you know Captain Anderson?
Met him a few times over the years. One of those hardcore military guys. Yes, sir. No, sir. Can't have any fun with a stick up your ass, sir. That's probably why he climbed the Alliance rank so fast. The military loves brown nosers.
The captain's a good soldier.
Sure, whatever. Dress him in a fancy suit, pin some shiny medals on his chest, and call him a hero. Everybody else does. But if he's so great, why'd the Spectres kick him out? Why'd you go ask him about that?
You need to look in a mirror. Sober up and take some responsibility for yourself.
Save your sermons. This ain't no church.
What's it like working for CSEC?
You mean, what was it like? The Executor suspended me without pay. Recurring violations. CSEC was keeping a file on me. Can you believe that? Every mistake I ever made went into the books. Get a little rough with a suspect, note in the file. Have a couple of drinks on duty, note in the file. Skim a couple of credits off a drug bust, note in the file. It's a goddamn witch hunt.
You got off easy, if you ask me.
What the hell do you know? Working for CSEC isn't like being a Marine. People get pissed off if we shoot somebody. Investigations, inquiries, rules, regulations. Every day I plow through enough red tape to choke a rhino. That's how you gotta be to do this job. So don't talk to me about right and wrong. You soldiers got it easy.
You need to look in a mirror. Sober up and take some responsibility for yourself.
Save your sermons. This ain't no church.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, good. Go. Let me drink in peace. Yeah? What do you want?
What do you know about Garrus?
Damn hothead is what he is. Still figures he can save the world. Always bucking heads with the Executor. He'll pay for it soon enough. The Executor loves to put us lowly field agents in our place. Just look what happened to me.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, good. Go. Let me drink it, please.
The back rooms are private, reserved for Fist and his friends.
Who's Fist?
He owns this club, but the customers have to stay out front.
Who's Fist?
He owns this club, but the customers have to stay out front.
Goodbye.
Enjoy the club. Human military, huh? Don't waste your time on me, kid.